Hi there. In this screencast, we're going to talk about something called Kling. Now, Kling is an interactive C++ interpreter that's built on top of Clang. Clang is a very hot topic in C++ nowadays, particularly because there isn't so much innovation, or there hasn't been so much innovation lately, and Clang is kind of the hot new thing. It redefines a few of our assumptions regarding C++. So Kling is particularly interesting because you wouldn't expect an interpreter for a kind of statically typed, compiled kind of language, but it exists anyway. So to get started with Kling, there are two ways. First of all, you can build it from sources, and this will work on most operating systems. I'm not sure about Windows. You might have some success on Cygwin, but I can't guarantee it. On the other hand, I go for the easy option, which is to get a binary. If we look at the kind of binaries which are available, you will see that there are binaries for Ubuntu, macOS, and Fedora. Now, I don't know about these two, but Ubuntu is something you can just download and set up a virtual machine. If you're using Windows, for example, you've probably got Hyper-V in there, or you can download VirtualBox, and then you simply download this archive, you unpack it, and that's pretty much it. You're essentially good to go. So now that you're good to go, you can set up SSH on your Linux box, and you can SSH into it, and you end up with something like this. So here is the actual Kling interpreter. Now, what you can do is you can type in ordinary expressions. So int n equals 5, for example, that gets interpreted correctly. If I evaluate the value of n, that gives me a 5. If I want to change the value of n, for example, that returns a 5, but then n itself is 6. Now I can use the standard library, obviously. So I can include, let's say, IOStream, and then do using namespace std like so, and I can see out the value of n. I can also see out, let's say, a smiley face, for example. Let's put an end line in here, just run it, and I get 6 and a smiley face. Now, Kling itself has plenty of what are called meta commands. Now, meta commands start with a dot, and you can find out all the meta commands by typing dot help. That gives you a listing of just about every meta command that there is out there. So they are all performing a specific function, like .l, for example, would load a given file or library. And that's useful because it basically loads the entire thing into the interpreter, so you can subsequently work with the functions that are defined there, which is extremely useful, shall we say. But at the moment, what we're going to do is we're going to experiment with a few other things like functions. Now, to define a function, you need to use raw input. I have no idea why. The description for raw input isn't exactly informative here. But let me show you how it works. So you switch on raw input, and then you can define your function. If you didn't have raw input on, you wouldn't be able to. It wouldn't actually accept the function definition. So let's define a simple function called increase. For example, we'll take an int x and just increase it by 1. Like so. So then you switch off raw input, and that's your function. Well, actually, you had your function before that. We could have left raw input. But essentially, we can now call increase on the n variable, and that gives n a value of 7. If I do it again, that gives it a value of 8, and so on. So you can see that the function works. Okay, so variables work and functions work. What about classes? Well, guess what? Classes also work. So let's try defining a class. So I'm going to have a class called person. Notice as I press return, there is some indentation here, which is useful, I guess, for defining these sorts of things. Although for the public block, I wouldn't really need indentation. So we define it. We have a public block, and here I will have person's weight and height, for example. Now, if I want a function for calculating, let's say, the body mass index, I would once again go into raw input, and now we can define the function. So let's do that. So let's have a float returning function called getBMI. So I'm going to return weight divided by height, like so. I will switch off raw input, and now I will put the closing semicolon and obviously the curly brace as well. So that's my class. I've got a class called person. I can say person p, and that creates it on the stack. And now I can say p dot height equals, let's say, 1.7. And I can say p dot weight equals, say, 70. And I can calculate the body mass index, p dot get BMI. Just call the function, and it gives me a value. Obviously, this is a an engineering notation value. That's how Kling works, and I haven't found a way to get it to use just, you know, ordinary floating point. But of course, since we have C out, we can try and do, you know, C out and do set precision 2, for example, and then p.get BMI. Now, of course, I'm not sure we have imported the right stuff for set precision, because that's something that is maybe in IOManip header. So once again, we include IOManip. Wait a second, invalid. Oh, wait, made a mistake. Include it should be. So include IOManip. And then we have to do using namespace std once again, because it only imports the stuff that you've already included. It doesn't include any of the extra stuff. So now we can try that set precision thing once again. And now we get a kind of value of 24. So this is an example of how you would output the values if you wanted them in a slightly neater way. Now, one thing to note about the standard library is you're not always going to have success with initializing types. So as an example, let's include sStream. I think that's for string streams. So I'll include that. I'll do using namespace std, and then I'll do ostring stream oss, something like this. And it worked. Because, well, a few moments ago when I was just preparing this, it was totally collapsing. But if it works, great, because then we can have string builders. So I can use it as a string builder and then do sort of OSS str. So, wait a second, that's another thing I should mention, the semicolon. Notice if I put the semicolon here, there is no output. But if I omit the semicolon, then it's like MATLAB. It will actually write it to the command line. The only question is, what exactly did it just write? Because oss.str is something that returns a string, and you can see that what we just got is some __ string type. So this is some of the stuff you have to be aware of when using Kling, that it will not always infer things correctly, which is why you should use either cout, as I'm doing here, like this. See, I've got my foo line in there, or you should be using cstdio, so printf and all that. It doesn't really matter which you use, but it's just a better output option. Now, you don't get any kind of code completion here, in the sense that if I press OSS dot and I kind of start pressing a tab here, you don't get any code completion. So it's not like a fully fledged IDE, but what it does let you do is it does let you very quickly load libraries and test theories and kind of calculate in a MATLAB style fashion. So if you're learning C++, or if you're already good with C++, but you just want some of that immediacy without having to recompile large libraries, then I recommend you check out Kling, because it works just fine and it's a fun tool to use. So thanks for watching, and take care.